Hey guys, it's Osher. Today we are going to play FIFA 17 with Valencia. So I am going to upload a video of FIFA 17 first career mode of my channel. It is of Manchester United and I think it should be up. I think it was uploaded yesterday if I'm right. So hopefully you have watched it, or if you haven't, there is a link in the description. Go watch it now. So let's continue with the introduction. I have just completed everything, all the details. I have filled every detail as possible, and we are playing on world class difficulty because this team isn't good enough to play on legendary right now. We are going to make some changes and that is going to help us. As I'm showing you in the background, the things our board needs us, like the shirt seals and important transfer information, and their vision and expectation for the season and for the next three seasons. So as I was saying, the team isn't good enough in the La Liga, and we have to improve this team like anything. So I have taken the 30% boost, and it hasn't boosted the budget as I wanted, because in the Manchester United video or in career mode, I got a budget of 135 million pounds, and in this we haven't got a huge budget. We are playing in euros, I think, if I am correct. But as you can see, there are few good scouts. I did get a new scout, and I am doing a squad report, and there are things I am thinking about. I am not going to sell Diego Alves, if that's how you pronounce the name. Hopefully I am correct about it. He is one of the best keepers in La Liga, if not the best. He should be higher rated than 83 because he deserves it. He is one of the best keeper in La Liga just because no one matches it. They haven't got any good keepers. They have Navas, but I think that's the, or maybe Jan Oblak, who is 85 I guess in this year's FIFA. And even Keylor Navas, who have just turned up in the last season. But no one like pay setters for the La Liga in the keeper wise. They have got great attackers like Messi, Suarez, Neymar, Ronaldo, Benzema, Gareth Bale, but not in the goalkeeper position, which they lack. And Real Madrid tried to sign David, but it didn't work. But I am going off topic right now. We have got Ezequiel Garay, who is a new signing, and Mangala on loan from Man City. On the right back position, we have got Montoya and Cancelo. I am going to play Cancelo as our first team player, and Montoya would be our backup. Mangala would go back to Man City if we don't hope to buy him at the end of the season. That depends on his performance for us, and I am not keen enough to using him because he is pretty bad in real life when he was with Man City. So I prefer not to use him, but just for the sake he is with us, I am going to use him. We don't have any problems at the center back position. Jose Gaya would be our preferred left back, and Sequeira, who has just moved on, no, he is on loan with us from Atletico Madrid. He is a good player, but we need a left back position once he goes back. And this guy could be our potential replacement for him. He is just 18 right now with a overall rating of 67, but we can train him and make him better than that. So it is going to help us in, I guess, the league, I guess, the board expectations. I think if this works out, I don't know about that. But we have got a left back of 66 and 21 only. He is 21. But I am going to sell him because he is 21 and he is pretty low rated. On the other hand, we have got this guy right mid. I thought when I was recording this, I completely forgot about this guy. And so I was like, we don't have a backup right mid. We are going to use Rodrigo as our striking position. So we don't have a right mid. This guy is on loan, as you can see, Roberto Ibanez, if that's how you pronounce it. But I was like, we don't have a right wing. And then I completely forgot. And when I was making a team for the match against our first friendly opponent, I realized that we have got a right mid. So we just need a backup striker, which we have got a player on loan, as you can see You will see now in the center mid, we have got Daniel Parejo, who is going to start, who is the first team, first name on the team sheet. With Enzo Perez, Mario Suarez is on loan. I don't know from where, from which team he is, he plays in, but still, if I can buy him at the end of the season, I am going to buy him, even though he is 29. Enzo Perez is 30 and 78 rated. I am going to buy a new center mid because we are going to play 4-3-3. And in that, three midfield players are going to be pretty useful. So we need a new center mid. Just a new center mid, because we have got two center mids as a backup. That is, one of them is Alvaro Medrano. If that's, I am really sorry because I am terrible at pronouncing name. English is not my native language. I am trying my absolute best. We have got few new, but young center attacking midfield positions, and we have got few nice young players, so it is pretty handy. Just like Vilabla, who is pretty nice at center attacking midfield position, and he can play at center midfield position, so it is pretty handy. So is Nacho Gil, if I remember correctly. He is a good center attacking midfield position, and I think even he can play at center mid. So if I can put him on loan or at least train him, he can be a good player for us. On the right wing, we have got Santi Mina, Rodrigo, and Zakaria Bakkali. I am terrible at pronouncing, as I told you. But Rodrigo can play at striking position, and I am going to use him there. And we have got Rafa Mir, who can play at the striking position too, with, I guess that is Munir, who is from Barcelona. So I am going to use Rodrigo, Rafa Mir in the striking position, get another striker. I guess I am not looking, and I am looking for a good center mid. So I am going to bring two new players to this squad. Munir is going to play for us. He is 74 rated at 20. So I need a new striker. Alvaro Negredo is on loan at Middlesbrough. So he has scored for Middlesbrough in real life. So that's a nice thing for him. But, and we have got Luis Nani there, and he is going to play on the left wing. So I can almost think about my first team with this squad report. Now, I am just going to keep two goalkeepers in our squad, and there are five goalkeepers in our team. So the other three would be sold off, and there are a few players I might sell on, but there are not that many players that I am going to sell in this first season because I don't know much about them. So I would be happy to use them before doing anything. Hopefully you guys understand it. So there are players who I can train, and there are players who I can play regularly. So it is going to be pretty helpful. So let's check out my shortlist for striking position. And the three strikers are Oliver Giroud, Mario Mandzukic, and Davy Selke, if that's how you pronounce the name. Sorry, I am actually sorry for that. I can't pronounce the name for sake. Oliver Giroud is the fourth striker in Arsenal. He plays behind Danny Welbeck, I think. In the sense of that, who would be the preferred striker. But I think we can get him for cheap because he won't get enough playing time at Arsenal. So it would be better to get him with us. Other player, he is 83 rated at 29. So he is pretty old, but he is at his peak right now. And I think he would be a better choice because we don't want someone young, because that would disrupt the growth of Rodrigo, if I can say that. Because Rodrigo is a good striker, and I want to use him with him, and I want to go ahead with this team into the European competitions with Rodrigo in my team. And he can play center mid and right mid position on the right wing, so that would be pretty nice. And Giroud, I can bring him on as a substitute because he is pretty strong, just like Mandzukic, who has played in La Liga with Atletico Madrid, but it didn't work. So hopefully we could bring him Mandzukic, same like Giroud. Mandzukic has Dybala and Higuain in front of him to get into the team. So it would be better off getting Mandzukic back into the La Liga. And for David Selke, I might the only reason he is on the shortlist is because he is pretty young, and at 73 he can be a nice backup, a backup's backup for in that sense. Now I think I am going to put them put in a bid for them, maybe in next few. Yes, I did inquire for them first of all, but Arsenal replied back with they asked for something 32.5 billion and I am not going to pay that much for a 29-year-old. So I did go in with 22.5 million and spoilers, they accepted. They accepted with no worries. And Juventus asked 35.5 million for Mandzukic. That is a big sum and I am not going to accept it. I'm going to put in a 23.5 million bid, which is accepted. Another spoiler, but before, let's play this match against Lokomotiv. I am putting a first team squad, no changes at all to this squad other than Miris playing in the middle because he in the striking position and he did want it to play. We get a draw against Lokomotiv. They missed a penalty in 5th minute and that was pretty helpful for us because if they could have scored, we could have been pretty terrible at the end of the match, but we get a draw. That's a first point in our friendly tournament, and as you can see, we are training. Miris getting some training. He is pretty young, so he needs a training. So is Mina, who is 76 rated. Hopefully he grows very well. And as I told you, Arsenal accepted the transfer bid from us and putting a contract for him. He was pretty stubborn with the contract. He wanted more money from us. Like he wanted, the player's demand was saying he wants 130k a week, but that's not the thing. That's a mistake. He wanted more than that, and that was pretty troubling because I wanted to save money because in the future we can't ask the board for more money, and that is where the problem arises. Even Juventus accepts the transfer bid, but even he does the same like Giroud. He wants more money and more money, and I can't afford that because in January transfer window, if I think I am not playing well then and I don't have enough money to buy someone else, I would be in big trouble. I can be sacked off there and thereof. So it was pretty troubling, and I was giving them money, but they weren't accepting it for some reason. For the first time they rejected it because of squad rule. But then it was pretty frustrating. It was pretty irritating because the video was going long, and now it's 13th minute and the video lasted for what, 40 minutes when I was recording it, and after editing it, it is almost 18 minutes. So it was pretty irritating when the player rejects even when you are matching the demands, and this is something where EA should look into, and I think they should look into this because they have to tell you the demands earlier or else you are going to waste your time in putting that effort, or you know, if you can understand me what I am saying. Now as you can see, I am making some changes to the team. I wanted to play a weak team against Porto, in a sense that a second team, not a weak team, but I wanted to make few changes to the team, so it works out very well. I wanted to give every player his chance and see what he does in the match. And as far as I am concerned, I am pretty happy with the skill moves every player has in the attacking position. Like Rodrigo, Nani and Munir are very skilled players, and so are benches. So I am pretty happy with it because I do like to do skills in the match and get past defenders. In this year's FIFA, passing is quite important. So even with passing and with some skills, we would be not so controllable by our opposition teams. So this is what I am looking forward to. Let's see in this match against Porto. Hopefully we could get a win, but spoilers, we get a loss because I was playing a second team and which wasn't strong enough to play against Porto, who are a good side in Portugal, but we could have defeated them, but I don't care enough because this is just a friendly. Now we get an offer transfer bid for Santos, our center back who is 27 at 77 overall, but I am going to reject it because I want him in the squad. I am going to use him. That's why I am going to reject it. Now Lazio offers for Diego Alves, and as I said before, I am not going to sell Diego Alves because he is a key player for us. He can be the single-handed winner for us or get a point for us single-handedly, and I am going to keep him no matter what. So it doesn't matter if you offer me 35 million or 15 million, I am going to reject it. So tata, goodbye Lazio. And as I said, Mandzukic did reject his contract. Now Olivier Giroud rejects his contract. I did give up on Mandzukic, and I did offer a new contract to Olivier Giroud, if I remember correctly. I am putting in a contract, but I don't remember about Mandzukic. Now I was looking for a midfield position, and the name is Gudelj. I have searched the pronunciation of this guy, and it is Gudelj. He is Dutch, and I am picking him up for our central midfield position. I am struggling to speak right now because I am ill right now, but we are simming a game against West Brom. This is the last match, and we get a win, so we get a total of 4 points from this friendly cup, and that wasn't good enough, and we were kicked out of the tournament. Now I am putting an offer for Carlos Bacca. I gave up on Giroud and Mandzukic because it was pretty frustrating, and I did give up on that young player also. So I did completely went for Carlos Bacca, and I am looking for this young center back from Ajax. He is 16 year old and just 63 rated. So his name is Lit. Going to offer him 825k a week. That should be good enough. And just wait a minute, I would be back. And so as I was saying, I am giving him a contract to this guy. He is pretty young, and he is just 63 rated, which is pretty high, even if you find a player from a youth scout. So I am going to get this guy and going to train him quite nicely. Hopefully he could get one of the best defenders in the world in next 4 seasons. I would try to do this career mode for 4 seasons, in keeping in mind that we have to qualify for Champions League first, and if we don't in this season, we have to do it next season. So it would be 4 seasons. I would be doing this career mode for 4 seasons just because I have to win everything, win the treble, I guess. Now this guy rejected wanted a better contract, so I am going to give him that. I am putting a crucial first team player, I am going to put in an important first team player. It was a bit of spoilers, but I think AC Milan accepted the. No, we are putting a bid for Carlos Bacca for 34 million. I am struggling right now because I am just back from that recording. I am pretty disjointed from that recording, previous recording. Now we are putting a bid for Alexander Lacazette, and Lit accepts his contract, and he is our first signing, which was pretty, like, I guess I don't think so. We thought of signing him at the beginning of the video. Now AC Milan accept the bid for Carlos Bacca from us, and we are putting him in a contract for him. And just like Mandzukic and Giroud, this guy was a trouble for me. He didn't accept his contract even after giving him what he wants. He wants more money, and that is something I can't afford when I am spending 34 million on a guy, and then he wants more than 100k a week. It is pretty frustrating. Now we are giving him a new contract, that is Gudelj, giving him a crucial first team player, but he is not going to play in the first team every week in week out. Putting in a bid for Gabbiadini. He is 81 rated at 24, so he is pretty young. young and younger than most of our players we tried wanted to sign or trying to sign. Now Gudelj accepts his contract and he is our second signing of the summer. So that is something nice. We have got the third backup center mid in the position. In that position. Now Napoli accept a transfer bid for Gabbiadini. That is something nice because he is a good player and we can use him in the striking position and on the right wing if I am correct. I don't remember correctly, but still giving him a contract, putting in crucial first team player and 60,000 a week. Just because he is cheap and he is young, I gave him extra bit of money, that is something 70k a week. Okay, 80. I think I went with 70k a week and everything else was pretty same. No changes at all other than the wages. Okay, I finally gave him 80k a week and he accepted it, luckily for us, because I was pretty happy with that. He was our third signing and the last signing we would make in this summer window. So he accepts it and he is our third signing and a striker what we needed. A top class one. Not a top class one, but a good one. So I was pretty happy with the way the video ended. Doing some training, the players have grown pretty nicely. Just like Mina, Santi Mina and me, they have grown pretty nicely in the last few trainings I have done. So I am ending the video right here. Thank you for watching.